here a couple of more numbers. We have DIT, which reported what was quite a disappointing set of numbers this quarter. Mr. Dilip Piramal, the chairman of DIT Industries, joins us with the details of Q4 for the time. Mr. Piramal, thank you very much for joining in. Let's talk about Q4 first. It's been an overall muted quarter for you. What have been a few of the defining trends for this quarter, which has led to the performance?
Well, the outstanding trend which I can point out, it's just been generally that the sales expense has been tapered. And I find that in some other consumer goods companies, the sales have actually fallen in the last quarter. So I guess that is a general trend.
Mr. Piramal, good morning. So we're getting mixed figures from the consumer company, but the 7.7% revenue growth for you for FY 2015 is lower than the 10% guidance that you had set out. Given the weak macro picture, will this be a realistic growth number for FY 2016?
What has happened is that one of our major institutional sectors has flat sales in the last year. And otherwise, our consumer sales, our own store sales in the last quarter was quite good. We have taken some measures to improve our inventory levels and all. And so I think for the coming year, that is the year which has just started, we are much more hopeful and we are looking at somewhere like 15% growth. And I think we should be able to achieve it.
Okay. So one of the, talking about the margins this quarter, one of the drives this quarter has been the surge in employee costs. In the past, conference call yesterday, we have spoken about revitalizing the sales force to push the VIP plan going forward. Could you tell us more about this strategy?
See, what has affected our margins is not only that the sales growth hasn't been all that much, you know, with the 7.5% sales growth, the expenses actually go at more slightly higher level. So the margins remain the same as they come down slightly. In the last year, we have increased our advertising. This reorganization of the VIP brand means basically that we are now focusing on all our brands, that our major luggage brands are Carlton, VIP and Starbucks. And we are advertising all three. Last year, we advertised all three, and even in the current year, we will be advertising all three. In addition to that, we have the Caprizi brand for handbags. And that also is a growing, it's a new brand, so we have to launch that, introduce that brand to India, and develop that brand. So where the sales expenses are quite high, we made some more films which also were quite expensive, they were shot abroad. So all in all, our advertising last year has been quite high, and with the growing, sales not growing as fast, I mean, that is there for all the industry. The margins are definitely under pressure, and if the price increases also are not possible, then the competitive situation is quite strong.
Okay, so you spoke about increasing ad spends as a key strategy for FY16 to push sales. What will be the ad spends as a percentage of the sales ratio for FY16?
Yes, we are increasing our advertising by about 1 percentage point or maybe 1.5 percentage point. And Carlton Handy is not a mature brand. It is, I mean, it was a foreign UK brand, but it was unknown in India. And since last year, we've followed a new strategy for Carlton, so it's virtually like relaunching Carlton. And Carlton is a brand in that this segment. And I think advertising has good results. We have good growth in Carlton, although the base is quite small.
Okay, you invested heavily into, you know, the newer brands like Caprice and maybe some more mature brands like Carlton. By when can we expect these brands to, you know, start contributing more meaningfully to your financials? What might the internal targets be?
What happens is that our main brand, VIP Skybags, they are very large brands. And they are about more than 10 times the size of Carlton and Caprice. So, and if they grow well, we are very happy. So, to compare the two brands, you know, and their relative strength and all, and their market shares within our company, or the composition of these brand sales in our total sales, is not, doesn't matter to us, because if VIP grows 15% and let's say Carlton grows 30%, we are very happy. But because the 15% of VIP is in a much larger base, VIP will still be a very large brand. So there are meaning, to address the question that Falcon is a meaningful brand, and if we have, if it is, so even if we have 50 crores in that segment, we are quite happy.
Okay, in the CSP segment, you lost a bit of market share to Safari. How big is this sales channel for you? And how much of a financial impact did you have because of this?
So I think what has happened with in the CSP segment was that Safari had, let's say, about in the 10 years, 3 years ago, in the period ending about from 2002 and 2012, they had lost, they had become very weak generally. And then there was a change in the management. And the new management was in fact now Australia managing director. And they had recouped some of the losses in the CSD. And in fact, I think probably CSD accounts for about 50% of the sales, total sales. But now I don't think that we will lose any further market share. But in fact, we are trying to regain some market share, and I think we have already done that. But there will be a new equilibrium, and our growth will be very good in that segment. In fact, we have got one very large institutional order in this quarter, which we will be executing in this quarter, and probably some of the clients still into July. So that will also be as a good booster to our sales in the first quarter.
Okay, and what is the size of this order, the quantum of this order?
Yeah, it's about a 50 crore order. We will publicize it at the new time, so I don't want to speak about it right now.
Okay, so you gross margins that impacted the current, due to the currency fluctuation also for FY15. Given the volatility that you have seen on currency front, what can you guide us for gross margins for FY16?
I don't think we are looking at very much of a margin expansion because we are investing heavily into advertising, into our new products. And I think we have to look at the long term. It's very easy for us to cut in advertising and increase immediate margins. But I think we're satisfied with content with what we're getting. And it is better definitely to build for the future. I think the Indian markets will explode sooner or later. The whole country was expecting much better economic performance in 2015. But I think that is also wrong because the expectations were, after the change of the government, there were a lot of expectations. But I think infrastructure and all development takes time. And the back of that will start coming. I feel it will start coming in the current fiscal year.
Okay, well, that point is taken and the optimism is welcome, Mr. Pyramid. But can you give us some guidance for FY16 in terms of revenue and profit margins?
Margins is a bit dicey at the moment because, like in the first quarter, which is our biggest quarter, the dollar has become quite strong. The rupee has become weak. So that's a bit, it's in a host of factors with higher advertising. I don't think there's going to be a very drastic change in our margin of profit.
Okay, one final question before we let you go. FY15 saw weak festive demand and sluggish trends. Are things looking better in FY16?
Consumer trends are very mixed. So it is very difficult to make any forecast. They are very mixed. They are different in different regions also and in different price points. And there is no clear-cut trend. But there is work, but it is people.
Okay, Mr. Pyramid, we'll give it a nap. Thanks very much for joining and speaking to us. So that's